Hello and welcome. You're listening to the Replay Podcast, recorded live on August 24th, 2017. I'm your host, Joel, and joining me, as always, is a big and star-studded cast today. We've got Jordan Sellers.
Hello.
Hello.
Back Mitch again. Drake.
Hi.
And Adam Seckley.
Hello.
It's a big group, big yeah. team today. Mitch is finally back.
Yes, I was only gone for a week.
Yeah.
It's true. It felt like a long time.
It did feel like
Joel
a long
was
time.
Lost without you.
I know.
Who do I argue with? No one here will argue with me.
No one here argues with anyone, I've noticed.
Exactly.
Lots of fun.
Remember, if you are listening live and you can't stick around for the full show, you can pick up where you left off on the following Monday on our iTunes, Wooshka, and YouTube page, links to which can be found on our Facebook page at facebook.com/replayAU.
Yep, we're actually live this week.
Yes.
Yes. Mitch was organized this week by being here.
Yeah, by being here. I was
Coming up on the show this week, we'll be talking about Gamescom 2017 or what's happened so far. Overwatch, which is our Blizzard segment, and Player on Battlegrounds stream sniping.
Yes,
again.
But we do have the quiz first up.
Yes,
as well.
The quiz. But before that, what have we been playing this week, guys?
Who are you asking first?
We'll go around. We'll go with you, Adam.
Still a lot of Assassin's Creed.
Mm-hmm.
My personal mission. Surprising.
Yeah. Just still trying to 100% all the games. So it's taken a while. I'm not sure whether I'll finish them all by Origins or not, but I'll give it a crack. Mm-hmm. And a little bit League of Legends as well, because Earth was still on this week.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Mm. Excellent. Me?
Yep.
So I didn't bring my my computer with me when I went overseas.
Mm-hmm.
So I just brought my DS and spent the whole time playing Animal Crossing New Leaf.
Animal Crossing. That sounds riveting.
Oh, it was. It really was.
It's such a casual game.
It is. But I needed that.
You needed time to relax, more or less.
I couldn't play anything intense.
Yep.
No.
Okay.
That's literally it.
Really? That's everything, man. That'd be a long week.
It was a long week.
And you're complaining about me playing just only League and Heroes of the Storm.
Yeah, you're just playing one genre of game.
I'm branching out.
I was playing a life simulator because I didn't have any friends.
You're supposed to go sightseeing in Fiji.
I can't go sightseeing in Fiji.
I've been playing... I actually bought a new game this week.
Well, what'd you get?
Interesting.
It's called Neon Drive.
Is that a driving game, or have you heard of this game before?
That's a brand new game that's like a week or two old, isn't it, right?
Is it?
That sounds about right.
I don't know. It was on sale for like $3, so I was like, sweet.
Oh, jeez, that's the most 80s looking thing I've ever seen.
And that is why I bought it.
Oh my God, it looks like Kit from Knight Rider.
Yep. So it's just kind of a... I don't know how to describe these games. They're like challenge games.
I know exactly how to describe this game.
How do you describe it then?
Audio Surf.
Ah, yes.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. And it was very challenging. Like even the first level, I was struggling. So
It was very visually noisy.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. It's very 80s inspired. It's got a nice 80s soundtrack.
Good.
Synthesizers and all that lovely stuff. So, I beat it all on easy difficulty.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And now I've gone up to hard.
Yep.
And struggling. Because on easy, you can take one hit, like make one screw up.
Yeah.
And it just kind of slows down and then keeps going again.
Mm.
That's so cheap at the moment, too.
Yeah, and you get checkpoints in easy mode. Like more checkpoints than you do in hard. So mm-hmm. hard, they reduce checkpoints. And if you hit anything, you have to start from the last checkpoint again.
Yep.
And there's only like two checkpoints to a
yep.
map. So, yeah, it's rough. I haven't tried Insane yet, so I'll see how that goes. I don't know if that ups the speed or what, if it just removes checkpoints completely. I don't know, but...
Saw it's also available on Android devices too.
Yeah, I saw that after I bought it. I was like, oh man, I couldn't...
You don't have an Android phone.
No, it's on iOS as well.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
And I was like, did I really just spend $3 on a game that I can play on my phone?
It was fine. There's nothing wrong with that.
But anyway, yes, I enjoyed that. It's a bit of a... It gets frustrating very easily.
I bet.
But yeah, it's fun.
I could see it.
It's
like,
fun when you win.
You're that close to the checkpoint, you just screw up and you just got to start all over again.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's very...
Mm.
And yourself, Joel?
I've been playing the usual League of Legends and Heroes of the Storm. Yep. But my friend gave me a free key for The Escapist 2.
Yep.
Which is now multiplayer.
Yep.
Within the game. So we've both been playing that for a bit.
And how have you been going with that?
I slow. I simply just, I don't know how to break out of the prisons. It's just, so I'm stuck doing the prison life, you know, lunch, workout, free time. That's about it.
That's brilliant.
And then
I found the first one of those games very easy.
See, I've played the first one and I just couldn't do it. I didn't know what was wrong. I didn't know. Couldn't do it.
Fair enough.
But didn't watch enough Prison Break.
I know.
Yeah.
And tomorrow starts Call of Duty Private Beta as well. So I'll be playing that.
Did you say Call of Duty?
Call of Duty.
You're not going to be able to finish any of your assignments then, obviously.
Of course I will. All tonight.
Screw Flanders.
Wow. Yeah. I don't know if I'll talk about it a little bit now, but I saw the gameplay for World War II, Call of Duty World War II.
Yeah.
Your thoughts? And
I was a bit...
disappointed?
Yes.
Yes, because we saw E3 footage, and then you're like, oh, that game looks great.
Yep. And now I'm looking at this, I'm like, oh. I was saying to Joel before the show, it's like, it's still Call of Duty.
Yeah.
The name's not going to change. The game's not going to change.
No, but it should have, is the point that we were making.
It did. Every single game leading up to it has been futuristic fly around the map.
Yeah.
Call of Duty. This is now what? World at War. Yeah. Boots on the ground from that point on.
Which is a good change.
Which is a good change.
It'll be a good change, but I don't think I'm going to get it anymore.
Really? No. You've been put off it completely.
Yeah.
See, I might still end up getting it just for the special multiplayer modes they said they were putting in, like the Battlefield-y kind of ones.
Yeah, but you play PUBG and Battlefield, then why would you get another game to play Battlefield?
Because I can't win in Battlefield.
Oh.
I suck at Battlefield now.
What makes you think it'll be good at this one?
It's Call of Duty.
Because
lots of 12-year-olds
I'm less reliant on my team. Don't have to count on my team as much to carry me. So
no, fair enough.
Or drag me down, should I say.
Some Overwatch feelings there.
Yeah.
Blaming the team, I get you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Had a bad week on Overwatch.
I'm sure you did.
Yes.
Do you want to kick off with this quiz?
Yeah, let's start with the quiz.
So it's the first week where all three of you competing. Which I'm very excited for. 5 questions as usual.
Yep.
4 on the last 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and 1 random trivia question.
Okay.
You ready?
Yes.
Yes. As ready as I'm going to be.
Yeah.
Laptop's down.
Oh. That's right. I can't do anything.
Yeah, you can't do anything on that.
Yeah.
Question 1. What is the name of the recent No Man's Sky update?
Ah, easy. What if I do?
Is
I get extra
the
points
full
if
name
I put
or
the
like?
It's 2 words.
Do I get extra points if I put the patch number in?
I have written down the patch number, but if you want to, yeah, okay. Go for it.
You just looked at this, didn't you?
No, I didn't, actually. Yeah. I just remembered that from last week.
Sorry. What is the name of Australia's newest reality TV show revolving around gaming? Is it A, so you want to be a pro gamer, B, the next gamer, C, the pro gamer, or D, the last guardian?
I like A.
I like D.
I think I'll go with D. D sounds
good. Yeah, D sounds pretty spot on, actually.
All right, you got that?
Yeah,
last got guardian. That? All right, 2. What list every game that's currently on the Blizzard desktop app.
Oh, my God.
Is it
I
1
swear
point...
I've had this question before.
You have, but it has been updated since.
Yeah. It has been updated.
Is it 1 point per correct game?
Yes.
Okay, here we go.
This is where I'm going to...
I think I got 2 and 3 mixed around, so just make a note of that.
Yeah.
There's a lot of games on this, actually.
There is. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 now.
8, okay.
Oh, my God.
It's a lot of points.
It is, but I know you've used this app, especially you, Jordan.
Yeah, but I only look at one thing when I get into this app.
I know.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We got 5.
Yeah, so there's 3 more.
3 more.
Yeah, but I only give you a couple more minutes.
Seconds. Yeah, we'll go with minutes. I need plenty of time for this one.
You'll be fine.
Oh, gosh. I reckon this is the same amount that I've written down for the
last
time.
There's been one more added since last time we did this.
Oh, yeah. I know the one that's been added.
No, you don't.
Do you, though?
You don't. It's not the Activision game.
How many did you say there were?
8.
What?
Is that Activision game not counted?
No, Activision game's counted.
Okay.
But it's not the Activision game isn't the most recent one added there.
Okay, I think I'm how many games did you say total? It was 8.
8. I'm on 7. I'm missing one.
I'm also on 7.
That's okay.
I hope you're wrong.
Okay. Question 4. What is the name of the Dota 2 card game?
Oh, yes, I know it.
I just looked at this.
I'm sure you did. It's also a type of card in Magic the Gathering, if that helps at all.
That does not help me.
That does not help me.
I'm feeling good about this quiz, except for that last, that Blizzard launcher question.
It's okay.
I'm still on that Blizzard launcher question. I'm still thinking of the very last one.
There's one last question. You ready for it?
Yeah.
All right, this is the random trivia question. What is a Geiger counter used to detect?
Yeah.
What is a Geiger counter?
Got it. I've got it. What? I know this one.
Can you use it in a sentence?
No. That's it. If I can get it, you can get it.
Yeah, it's quite a well-known piece of knowledge.
Can you say it again?
What is a Geiger counter used to detect?
Geiger counter.
It makes popping sounds.
Please stop giving clues. I would like this point.
Okay, we done?
Yes.
All right.
I got nothing for 5.
It was a quick quiz.
Yeah. Well, if there's a tie, there's one more question.
Oh, right. I want to hear that. Okay.
So Joel has no extra points this week, does he? He's just...
No, there's no extra points.
Right, I did nothing for it. I was unprepared. As soon as Mitch said, I was like, oh, yeah, we got the quiz this week.
Yeah. I need... can I grab my pen?
Yeah.
So, I just need to... I'm going to write this down too. Look, bit of...
bit of paper flicking noises.
Yeah, a bit of radio effects.
I have a feeling I'm going to be doing my challenges this week.
I don't know.
I'm still trying to think that final game that's on
there. It's okay. You'll hate yourself.
No, yeah, trust me. I'm going to hate missing myself. It's something.
It is something. It's great. What is the name of the recent No Man's Sky update, Adam?
I didn't have anything.
Joel?
Atlas Rises.
Yes.
I had Atlas Rises 1.3.
Well, you both get a point.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah. we'll go the Blizzard desktop app. What have you got?
So Diablo 3, yep. StarCraft 2, StarCraft Remastered, Overwatch, Heroes of the Storm, Destiny 2, and Hearthstone.
Oh, Heroes of the Storm!
So you didn't put World of Warcraft in there, did you?
Damn it. That was the one I was missing.
These are all games I know too, but I didn't even...
So, hang on. I took too many notes. What was yours?
The exact same. Diablo 3, StarCraft 2, Hearthstone, Overwatch, Heroes of the Storm, and Destiny 2.
How did I forget WoW?
I know.
It was always about one game.
I had Overwatch, Destiny 2, StarCraft 2, Diablo 3, Hearthstone, StarCraft Remastered.
Okay, you all got WoW, which is not the one I thought you'd forget.
Yep.
That's terrible.
7 points.
Which was StarCraft Remastered the new one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it's now on the launcher on the side.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I see it there. It's so obvious. It's just like the Destiny one. It's very obvious.
I can't believe you forgot WoW. That's insane. All right. Question 3. What's the name of Australia's newest reality TV show? What's your answer?
I put B.
That's correct.
I put B.
Yep.
Oh, you didn't. I put B too. I thought you guys got it wrong. Because you said, yeah, I'm going for D.
You seriously think I'd put... What was D again?
The Last Guardian.
Yeah. Really? It's a game, not a TV show.
All right. What's the name of the Dota 2 card game, Adam?
I have no idea.
Joel?
Artifact.
That is correct. Jordan?
Artifact.
Excellent. And finally, what is a Geiger counter used to count, Adam?
No idea.
Jordan?
Nothing.
Radiation?
That's correct.
I only know that because of Fallout 4. And yes. Fallout games.
1, 2, 3.
See, this is what I get for not playing Fallout. 7, 8.
Well, I don't lose.
I think Joel got that one.
Joel won. Jordan came second with 9, and Adam came last with 8. Do you want to know the tiebreaker? It won't count for any points.
Yes, I do. Yeah.
What is Muhammad Ali's birth name?
Oh, I didn't know that. Is that
Tyson.
A trick question?
No.
No? I was going to say...
It's not.
It's not a trick question where it's actually just Muhammad?
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
It's Cassius Clay.
Oh.
How did you not know that? You're like the 80s king.
I've never watched an Ali movie.
Oh, wow. Yeah. All right. Anyway, that's the end of the quiz. So, Adam, your challenges.
Yes.
Adam's challenges are to complete Act 1 of the main story in Diablo 3 on Torment 5 with a wizard.
Ouch.
With no armor whatsoever, which includes rings, only hand items.
It's going to be a struggle.
That is a struggle.
Yeah. It'll be a struggle.
And that was even talking down from like 13 to 10.
I was going
to
go 13.
13 was impossible.
Yeah, yeah.
Your opposition one was to get 1 kill in PUBG whilst wearing a ghillie suit. And your opposition two was to gather all feathers in Assassin's Creed 2.
That one's doable. Just grinding.
It's grinding.
Yeah.
Because how many feathers are there? There's like
100.
Just straight 100?
100, yeah.
All three of these are very grindy.
Mm.
Oh, two of them, I feel like actual... Like, the Diablo one sounds like an actual challenge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where you need to actually think of when... Where to be positioned.
To yeah.
Because when you get to the Lich King, I feel like as soon as he just teleports onto you, you're just straight dead.
Yeah.
He's a wizard. He's got blink, don't you?
That's not not at like early levels.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
So, it depends whether I want to like try and level up or stay at a low level.
Yeah.
Well, it's up to you. You just go complete Act 1 on that difficulty without armor as a wizard.
Oh.
I'm so very coffee today. I'm so sorry.
And that's the quiz. I won, finally.
Well done, Joel. Well done.
I didn't lose because you won this time. It's great.
So we have
victory music. Thanks for joining in, Adam.
No worries. But
can't wait till the next month quiz. That's going to be great. So, yes, you have 1 month to complete those.
Ah, easy.
We'll see.
Yeah.
Famous.
Ready, Jordan? We'll party up in PUBG, and I'll get the ghillie
suit. We'll stream snipe him.
Yeah, we'll stream snipe him. I'll get the ghillie suits. I'll get the kill.
Yeah.
You're not going to be streaming, are you? You can if you want. That's
add me on Steam so I know when you're playing PUBG.
All right.
Yeah.
I might record it.
Because you're going to have to rush for those crates now. That's the only chance you got to get in the ghillie suit.
I saw a video of someone with a car and they picked it up as it was dropping and then drove off with the crate.
But that's also a very fine art of timing there. Yeah.
I think that's just luck, really.
Yeah. Yes.
So, Gamescom's been going on.
Yes, it has. It's been
I've seen none of this, except for the Blizzard segment.
Oh, really? I didn't even know Blizzard were doing a segment at Gamescom.
They kind of just did three videos.
Yeah, because they've got... What have they got? They've got BlizzCon coming up soon.
Yeah, they just announced Kalthazar, that's it.
Yeah.
But we'll talk about that after you get us through the Microsoft panel.
Yes. So, there wasn't, like... I don't think Gamescom is really that... big, because it's only been a couple months since E3, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So also, why is it called Gamescom?
That's a good question.
I'll have a look.
But I do agree. I feel like it's like a lower end of
it's
E3.
It's
kind of
just like
more
a reminder of people going like, this stuff's happening. Check it out.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there's not any big news. There's a few cool little tidbits here and there. But you can now officially pre-order an Xbox One X.
Are you going to?
Me?
Yes.
No, I don't ever need to at all.
So you're not going to get an Xbox One X at all?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe if my Xbox dies one day, I might think about
that
it.
That can be arranged.
Mitch just rocks up with the hammer. So there are now more than 100 confirmed Xbox One X enhanced titles, including Wolfenstein 2, a new trailer for Middle of Earth Shadow of War. We got a really, really cool cinematic for Assassin's Creed Origins. If you haven't watched that, I suggest you should.
I will have a look at that after the show.
It is very cool. You get to see... It kind of shows the figures and stuff you'll be encountering in the game and hopefully assassinating. Or
is it the Anubis-looking guy with the mask and stuff?
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, okay. I saw a brief thing on that one.
Yeah, yeah. It looks like lots of fun. That actually kind of sold me on the game a little bit more. Even though it's a cinematic, the game will look nothing like that.
How about you, Adam? Did it sell you on the game?
I was already sold on it. It got announced. Yeah.
Doesn't take much for you. Yeah. Assassin's Creed game.
But there's also a lot of gameplay that's been released as well. And there's been huge improvements since E3, so I'm very happy.
I haven't seen any gameplay since E3.
I got heaps of links to send you.
I think I'm just going to stop watching anything to do with this game. I'm just going to get it on launch and just appreciate, like, be surprised.
You're getting an Assassin's Creed game on launch?
Yes. I'm taking
it's
the game.
Not really...
Okay. I'm even getting it on PC, which is probably the most risky platform to get it on.
Good luck. I hope it can run it.
Yeah. But I thought this was cool. Sea of Thieves, we were talking about this during E3. We were a bit unsure about crossplay in Sea of Thieves.
Only on Xbox.
Now been confirmed that it will be crossplay between PC and Xbox.
Only if you buy it on Windows 10,
Yeah.
So happy. So happy.
Yeah.
Because I know I'll be getting it on PC.
Now that I know it's going to be crossplay, I'll be like, I can get it on a PC now. No worries.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't have to stress about leaving anyone behind or like something like that. Microsoft announced it would publish definitive remasters of Age of Empires 2 and 3, as well as completely new sequel, which is Age of Empires 4.
Good.
Which we all saw.
Finally.
Yes.
Finally.
So good to see that.
Yeah.
Then again, like the trailer was just like...
I never played
like,
Age of Empires, so I don't...
The trailer was like just a through the ages type of thing.
Yeah.
Which showed no gameplay of the game at all.
No, but you don't... You know what Age of Empires is going to be.
You do, but is it... What kind of Age of Empires is going to be? Is it going to be like the story-based thing where it was Age of Empires 3 where you have your own market town type of thing? Or is it Age of Empires 2 or 1 where you just jump straight into a game? And
Age of Empires is an RTS, is it?
Yes, it is.
Okay. It is, but it had like some kind of story in Age of Empires 3.
2 did as well. 2 had a story as well.
Did it?
Mm. It's going to be like Warcraft 3 where there's a story and then there's going to be multiplayer.
Okay.
That's...
Mm.
So it's interesting. I'm looking forward to it.
I don't know if you guys remember...
So sorry.
That's right.
Recall, that was the Xbox exclusive, I think, from like
last with
year.
With the robot dog?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a definitive edition coming for that.
What makes it definitive? Wasn't it not very good?
Yeah, I played the demo. I got to play on the Windows 10. You used to play a demo for like 7 hours worth of the game or something.
Yeah, yeah, which is probably enough to beat it.
7 hours?
No, I don't think it was 7 hours. It was like I think it was two.
That's a long gameplay demo.
It would have been 2 hours, and I played that, and I was just like, nah, I didn't like it, so I didn't buy the game.
Fair
and,
enough.
Didn't look interesting to me.
Yeah, I don't think it sold too well either. Like, there was a bit of hype about it.
Was there a release date at all? All we saw was just, we just saw it again.
Yeah, pretty much. That's what I saw anyway.
They're really delaying it, and it's getting no hype at all.
Oh, it's out.
Oh, it's out now?
Yeah, it's out. This is definitive edition, so they're re-releasing it.
Right.
And like with HD graphics and stuff.
But it was released on the Xbox One.
There's 4K graphics then.
So they're reselling it with a patch.
Yep. If you are in the game now, you get the Definitive Edition for free.
Sounds just like Skyrim.
So it's a patch.
Yeah. It's a patch.
Wow.
That's
dumb as hell.
So, Just double up on notes. But yeah, that's about it from Microsoft.
Really?
Yeah, there's a full list of Xbox One X enhanced titles. If you want to go through it, it's on. If you just Google that, you can have a look.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I don't really think we need to rattle through the list.
No, people are sick of Microsoft already.
Yeah. Nintendo, that was just yesterday for us. So that would have been Wednesday of Gamescom. We get a SNES-inspired 3DS XL is coming to Europe on October 13th.
Fair enough.
I thought this was fake when I saw that picture.
Cool.
I thought someone just like, you know.
It looks cool, but then I realized I don't play on my 2DS.
No.
It looks just like a fan-made thing, and I was like, okay, that's cool. It's someone made that thing.
Yeah.
It's coming. It's happening.
It's a good idea to release it about the same time as the NES Mini, SNES Mini.
Yeah. Also, as a side note, I think the SNES Mini has sold out everywhere.
I'm not too excited to get it.
Because
I don't think I'd buy an NES, like a physical one.
Yeah.
But I would buy an SNES.
Okay. Well, that's fair.
Sold out completely.
So far, the first wave.
Okay. Yeah, it's okay. Like the first wave.
Although we know like, that's it. That's the end of the
year. No, they won't do that. They're going to keep producing it until Christmas, remember?
Okay.
So a new food-themed Luncheon Kingdom for Super Mario Odyssey has been revealed.
Let me take a look at that.
I have no idea what that is.
Neither do I. I'm not too sure. But this is cool. The Nintendo Switch version of Rocket League will contain exclusive battle cars based on Mario, Luigi, and Samus.
I saw the Samus Aran one.
I saw the Samus one.
I haven't seen them, but I just knew looking at that, I was like, oh, they're going to be cool.
The Samus one looks so like neon, futuristic, 80s themed type of thing.
I'm kind of sad that I can't just buy those for PC.
You probably could if you bought the Switch version as well.
Do you reckon? Oh, I guess crossplay.
Yeah, yeah. You're going to be able to link your account.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's a lot. What am I paying? Like $70 for 3 car skins?
How much do you like Rocket League?
Not that much. I haven't played it for like a month. I've been playing Lucio Ball, which is
same game.
Yeah. So 3 new games have been announced for the Nintendo Select 3DS range. So Super Mario 3D Land, Luigi's Mansion 2, and Kirby Triple Deluxe.
Luigi's Mansion 2.
It's a cheaper version.
Wasn't the first... Is there already a Luigi's Mansion?
All those games are already out. They've just released them into like the budget range.
Yeah.
For like $30.
So they're considering dropping the price a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. All right, okay. Because I was thinking, wasn't like Luigi's Mansion on GameCube?
Yeah, and then they released Luigi's Mansion 2 on the 3DS.
Oh, okay. All right.
Pokemon Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon pre-orders are now open. I don't see the point.
Pokemon, guys.
I hate sequels. We love Pokemon. Games.
Gold and Silver package editions can now be pre-ordered.
No, I've got Gold and Silver physically.
Yeah. And Fire Emblem Warriors is coming to 3DS and Nintendo Switch in autumn and has a new trailer.
That's pretty cool, though. Mm? Having the same game on the Switch and the DS is interesting.
Do you think it'll be the same story?
Yeah, it'll be exactly the same game. It'll just be low-res graphics, so like pixel art graphics on the DS, and then really up-res, beautiful graphics on the Switch.
Mm. It'll look nice.
It might have crossplay too. I don't know.
Sony kept pretty quiet at Gamescom.
Well, hey, this is a big thing. This first one.
Sony keeping quiet's pretty big. Yeah.
Shenmue 3 PS4 launch. PS4 trailer. Sorry.
Shenmue 3.
Shenmue 3.
Wasn't that a Sega Saturn game?
It was an old game. When was Shenmue 2 released and what was it released on? Because I know it wasn't new.
I'd say maybe PS1, PS2.
That's what I mean.
Dreamcast.
Was Shenmue 2?
It was on Dreamcast and the Xbox in 2001, Shenmue 2.
And now we have a new game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That many
it's
years.
It's on PlayStation, which is didn't even have Shenmue 2 on it.
No, but Dreamcast was essentially a PlayStation.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so, and they gave us a new Destiny 2 launch trailer.
Another one.
Yep, there's a cool shiny GT Sport Edition of the PS4 Pro.
Because of... Same reason they made the Minecraft Xbox One.
Yes, I think it's Need for Speed Payback related or Gran Turismo, I'm not sure.
I'd say Gran Turismo GT, maybe.
Yeah, and Uncharted was playable on the floor. There's also Destiny 2 was playable while you're there. And they had this new PlayLink thing. Have you seen that?
No.
I looked into that. It was kind of cool. You know how you... What's that game called where you play it on your phone and it's like...
You take the photos on the phone and you play on the screen? Yeah, I know.
It's...
Like Drawful?
Kind of like
it's
Drawful.
Kind of, but it's a PlayStation made and based one.
Yeah.
Where it's linked to your phone type of thing.
But, and you like take photos of each other and the challenge is to like make this person look like a cop or something and just scribble on them.
Okay. Yeah.
It's just kind of like one of those vote games.
It's a voting game.
Yeah.
As in you take a photo of yourself at the very start and then it'll be as in like...
game essentially.
Yeah,
it's a digital board game.
Yes.
Yeah. So Blizzard... Blizzard, I didn't realize, I think I said this before, I didn't realize they were there, but so we got some Warcraft news.
Yeah, we got the latest patch, which is going to have you visiting Argus the Vindicator. I didn't spell that right.
Vindicar.
Vindicar. Oh, maybe it is Vindicar.
Vindicar.
The first zone you'll visit is Krokun, native to the Krokul, and you just go through some stuff. It's just another dungeon, I think.
Yeah.
The Hearthstone Fireside Gatherings now have raid fights similar to Pokemon Go raid fights.
Mm.
So multiple people versing one.
Wait, at the same time?
Yeah, so Hearthstone does this thing called a Fireside Gathering where you can set up a network to be an official Hearthstone location.
Yeah.
And the people that are using it all get to play together in special game modes and stuff like that, and that's one of them. Which you're versing the Lich King.
Right, okay.
Which is pretty cool. And they released a very Disney-esque
yes, we all watched that before the show.
And what did you think of that?
It looked interesting.
It was fine.
Yeah. I just, as I said to you, I was like, that's a lot of time and money spent making this amazing, Disney short film on a barely 3D game.
Have you seen the trailers for all of, the WoW expansions?
No, I haven't. No.
Oh, man.
It's like they go out all out, and at the end of the day, all you do is put cards down. I guess it does get people excited, and that's the purpose. Yeah.
I think when people watch those trailers, they get really excited, like with you with the Assassin's Creed trailer.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess that's fair.
And they're trying to revamp games that already exist, too.
What do you mean?
Like they're trying to get people excited for a game that already exists.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I see what you're saying.
And we also got an animated reveal of Kalthu's art.
Oh my god, looks so good!
What do you think of this hero?
The trait passive that he gets to me, it sounds really
strong.
The
spell damage increase.
The spell damage increase, which sounds by 75%, sounds I hate to say the word, but broken. Like at the very start, I hate saying OP, broken. I hate being the person to say the word, but it's he sounds pretty crazy. But
how do you feel about the chain?
It's different. It's unique, actually, because to be able to just lock someone down from like attached to someone and then go into a wall, more or less.
Yeah,
it seems pretty nice. One of the abilities, because I always like correlate between different games, in the same genre type of thing, where the chain to me is like in League of Legends, one of Zach's abilities, where he attaches to someone, attaches to someone else, and then slams them together.
Yeah,
that's the extent of what.
But it doesn't do it to structures.
No, it doesn't stun. Mm. No, in League of Legends, no, it doesn't do it to structures, just enemies. But it looks nice.
Works with turrets.
Does it really?
Yeah. So if you like latch yourself onto, say, you know, someone else, and then you hit a turret, it'll pull them in.
I had no idea.
Yeah. Well, if it's something you can attack, it works.
Okay. Okay.
So do you think that you'd pick up this character?
No, not from the get-go.
No.
I'm not the best at. I think he's more of a ranged assassin.
Yeah, I haven't played a lot of ranged assassins, but I'm keen for this guy.
Would you buy him straight out like you did with Garrosh?
No.
No, yeah.
I pick him up for 10k, not 15k.
See, it's like the same thing with Garrosh. I think they do the same thing as always, but I don't know what's happened with Garrosh, where they release someone who sounds really strong.
Yeah.
And then once everyone's bought him, they'll nerf him. Nerf him to the ground.
Yeah. But Garrosh is getting a boost.
Garrosh getting a buff? I don't know why they would do this.
It's the MOBA talk, and Jordan's got the MOBA face.
He does.
I just wanted to say, actually, we got a comment. I don't know how long ago this was, so sorry, Joel. But Joel Hodges listening. He said, my heart broke today when I realized that Red Dead is delayed. I'm like, that was a while ago.
We don't need Red Dead, apparently.
Yeah. But yes, it is sad news, Joel. But
as an Overwatch fan, Jordan, how do you feel about the May short?
I thought it was really cool. Mm. I enjoyed that. Because I never really understood where May's place in Overwatch was.
Yeah.
Because she kind of felt like too normal, I guess.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone's got these really over-exaggerated things, and she's just got this ice gun, which I guess is an exaggerated ice gun. But
yeah. What was the short? Like, explain. I didn't see it.
So it was like she was part of a research team. I'm not sure where they were. It was somewhere cold.
Yes.
Snow.
Obvious.
Yes. They had to go into hibernation because they're running out of food or something. Mm. And they ended up waking up 9 years later. Or she woke up, no one else, everyone else died.
Ooh.
And she was stuck on this little isolated.
It was like Alien Resurrection or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And then, she kind of just built her way out making tools and stuff. And the tool that she made was her ice gun. She had to try and fix the tower so she could get reception somewhere. And then when she got reception, she saw the video of Winston talking like, all agents of Overwatch.
It's the opening.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
And after that was EA, wasn't it? The next one is EA, because that was the last thing.
Oh, right, EA. Yeah, sorry. I thought we were still talking about Overwatch for a second.
No. That's okay. I don't want to spoil it, but you guys should go and watch that.
The May thing?
Yeah. It's again, Blizzard does amazing cinematics.
Was it like an emotional type of thing?
It was, actually.
Mm, okay.
It was kind of cool.
Mm.
Right.
So EA gave us some new, very cool trailers for Battlefront 2.
Are you still a fan of Battlefront 2? You actually still interested with what Battlefront 2 is doing?
I'm enjoying what they're doing. I'm getting excited for it.
Okay. Interesting. Yes. Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Yeah. The whole, I think it was Starfighter Assault is what they showed us.
I did. I watched that before the show. That was the in-space fighting thing.
And I watched some gameplay of it too, and I thought that looks fun.
Is the trailer that I watched exactly like the gameplay?
From the gameplay, there's three different phases from the map that I saw anyway.
Yeah.
It's like a Starfighter Assault. That makes sense. it's a Starship Destroyer thing.
Yep.
You know, the big ass thing that Darth Vader usually cruises around in.
Yep.
And so I think you're trying to take that down, but you got to destroy certain things along the way so you can get to it. So it's kind of like destroy these three ships so they don't gun down all the infantry or something. And then the next phase is destroy the shields. And the next phase is destroy the Star Destroyer.
Is there like one weakness to the Star Destroyer? You got to fly very precisely into shoot little.
I think you do have to fly in somewhere okay. and get in pretty close. But yeah, I think there's a lot more hero gameplay in this one too. Because mm-hmm. I think at one point they had Poe Dameron's Black One X-Wing.
Yeah.
Darth Maul going. I saw Han Solo, Millennium Falcon in there. Okay. And Slave One all happening at the same time. So there might be four heroes in this one.
Yep.
Because, yeah, we only ever had two at one time
yep.
previously. But, yeah, I'm excited for that. I'm probably going to buy that game and play the hell out of it. First chance I get. Mm. What's more exciting, though? You know what's more exciting? The yes. FIFA 18 trailer.
Oh, my God. I've been waiting for this game to drop and yes, finally yes. been able to see
it's
it.
It's been a solid year since the last time we got a FIFA game.
Instant pre-order.
Yeah.
yeah. Instant pre-order. That game's just like Call of Duty is made every year and I just get it every time.
Yeah. yeah.
So many changes. I'm so excited.
You get to keep the ball this time.
They're even continuing the story from the last one.
yes.
I can't even believe. I'm surprised they're actually doing that. Because I feel like the story would have been like a one-time thing.
I wonder if anyone's died since the last game was released. Like any of the players, and they've just ignored it completely from the storyline.
Oh, right. Like...
Because these people are crazy. They're all hopped up on drugs and whatnot. It's the same thing as like...
Football. Yeah, no, they're actually pretty good with that. They even patch the game when players swap teams, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, like, soccer fans are crazy.
Not like lower-end teams, like if you're talking about like the England BPL.
Yeah.
Like the Manchester United, yeah. Manchester City... All that kind of stuff. They're all pretty switched on there at EA. They know what the soccer fans want.
That's and I used to be one of the game they keep doing.
Yeah. and hey, if it working. Makes some money, like, yeah, yeah they got to do it.
Do you know, in, I think it was 2016 was the last FIFA game made for the PS2.
Really?
Yeah, I think so. I'll Google that, but it's like.
PS2.
Yeah.
PS2, no.
Yeah.
That can't be right. That seems too late.
It sounds just like the...
it was like Brazil.
Like
or I guess it'd be like the classic soccer fan that never really... Like some dad somewhere that's still playing
FIFA 2014 was the last PS2 game made.
That's still pretty recent. Yeah, like yeah. I was playing FIFA 2014 on...
Xbox One, probably.
It reminds PS3, me the same yeah. of the wrestling games. I feel like the wrestling games also made just like the FIFA where
yeah.
they're always updated for the PS2 games and stuff.
I used to hate wrestling, but still...
PS2's so old.
I know,
it's still fine.
It's still...
I play my PS2 constantly.
So. I actually really want to try that now. FIFA 14 on PS2. I
wonder how much it is.
Graphics comparison between FIFA 14, PS2 and yeah. what?
FIFA 14 was my... Okay, so I went through a phase a couple of years ago where I'd constantly play FIFA. I don't
You're
even
so
play.
Interesting.
I played club soccer for 1 year and when I was a kid. And that's my extent of soccer knowledge. Like my family is pretty big on soccer, but I never really got into it.
So FIFA 14 was released on PS2, PS3, PS4, Xbox and Xbox One.
Jeez.
Keep in mind that PS2 was made in 2000.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my God. I really want to know what that looks like. There's probably a YouTube video I can look up after this.
I was just seeing if I can find a price. You get an Xbox One for $5.
What?
No. That's how much your childhood is worth.
Oh, you mean Xbox...
$57.
You mean Xbox Original.
No, Xbox One.
Xbox One.
As in the one you currently have, yes. Yeah,
the for $5.
For $5.
No.
Or you can buy it for PS2 for $52.
No. Oh, you mean way. The game?
Yeah.
On Xbox. Oh, if you said you just... An Xbox One straight up $5.
And why I was would like, I say what? That?
I don't know. That's why I was like, oh, so you mean Xbox Original?
No, you infer from context.
Wait, you know a guy selling one for $5?
Yeah, yeah. I was like, I'd buy it for myself just to have two. but this is another cool note from EA. EA just switched on, man. They know what the gamers want.
Do they?
And they showed us a new BMW M5, which will be playable in Need for Speed Payback.
Oh, my God.
So what's a BMW M5?
It's a new car.
Is it?
Yeah. I don't know what it looks like, but it's a car.
Okay. Is that a selling point? Is it just because
it's a new car that'll be able to play and drive it?
So it's for the people that can't afford those cars
yep.
to just play the... Okay.
That's why they buy the game.
Yeah,
exactly.
Sweat the taste buds a little.
That's hey, so Need for Speed, have you seen much of the Payback game?
No.
I've seen a little bit. Oh, I just, whenever I think of Need for Speed Payback, I think of the E3 stuffer. hey guys, it's Jesse. here to talk about Need for Speed Payback.
Oh, hi, Mark.
You're going to talk to my buddy Mark over here. He's Mark. He's my buddy Mark. Yeah. He's here to talk about Need for Speed Payback. I'm a YouTuber. Oh God,
with a hell of a screw up.
Yeah, but it does look cool.
It doesn't look too bad.
Yeah,
I've never seen a Fast and Furious movie.
That's essentially what this game looks like.
I know.
Yeah,
that's why I'm not going to get it.
Oh, you should. Yeah, maybe give Fast. Have you seen Point Break? No, that's a stupid question to ask you. Yeah, starring Keanu Reeves.
I watch good movies.
Oh,
Tokyo Drift. Good one. That's a good one there.
No, not Tokyo Drift.
What? It's the best one.
No.
Yes.
Have they ever made a Need for Speed game? Not Need for Speed. Fast and Furious game.
Forza Horizon 2. There was
Fast and Furious.
No, but bear with me. There was DLC, which was Fast and Furious DLC.
Yes.
And that released when count? I think 7 came out. The one where Paul Walker passed away.
It doesn't really count, though. It's DLC. I wouldn't really say full.
You can't really see the people in the cars.
It was pretty cool, though. Like, you got all the cars from the movie.
The Rock yelled at you because you were too slow.
No, there was no voice.
Did I get to play as Paul Walker? Did I get to play as Paul Walker?
No, there's barely any.
Then how is it DLC?
Huh?
You get the cars.
You just get the cars. You drive around the cars. You feel like a badass. Driving around in Vin Diesel's car with the big the hood scoop in it and the engine thing, the big ass intake fan thing.
There was around with the engine thing?
Yeah, yeah.
2006, The Fast and Furious, it was based off Tokyo Drift.
Oh, wow.
It was just it's just called The Fast and the Furious for PS2.
PS2. Yeah. Oh, that's why I haven't heard of it.
I would love to see you talk to a car enthusiast.
Man. Oh, yeah. I love it when they
talk to me. My brother's a mechanic. I can bring him in.
Oh. I've spoken to your brother before.
Yeah. Yeah.
He didn't grill me too hard.
No, but you didn't talk to him about cars.
No, I didn't.
Please talk to him about cars.
That's what I love talking to car enthusiasts. It's like, oh, yeah, cool. Yeah. Yeah, so
we should do an interview show where we take Jordan to like a hot rod thing and he has to interview people.
So what's under the hood? He's like, an engine.
No, he doesn't say an engine. He says oh, this. I can't really talk. Nothing.
So what?
But he will explain it like to detail.
Yeah.
And you'll have to go,
So I get that people like cars too because it's like the same kind of way. Like I know everything that's inside a PC. Yeah, I look at that the same way.
Yeah.
Like what's under the hood? Like,
you can only do one thing with a car.
I got a GTX 1060, Intel i5. You know, I could go through all the specs and stuff. Like, same way.
Just the graphics card and the processor.
Yeah, I know, but I didn't want to go on forever.
What motherboard do you have?
Huh?
What motherboard do you have? Look, he's stumped.
MSI Crate Gaming 3X.
There you go. Is that with a question mark?
No, that is with certainty.
Several exclamation points.
Because I heard like MSI with the crate.
It's okay.
And I've got something MSI, and that's the only
something
thing.
Something MSI.
Before we get too far off tangent, do you want to bring us back to the Bethesda announcements? Or is there any more EA?
Unless we're talking about Sims 4.
Sims 4,
that's fine. I'm okay with not dealing with that.
What's wrong with Sims,
The last good Sims game was Sims 2 Pets for the GBA.
No, GBA? Man, you've been missing out.
Literally the only box Sims GBA 4. Game I've got.
Cats and Dogs expansion.
Sure, Cats and Dogs. It's like, why? Sims is a good game. I don't mind it. I'm excited for it to coming to PS4 and Xbox. I'm telling you that one.
I have the original on the Xbox, actually.
The original?
Sims.
Okay. Because I got Sims 2, I think, was a PS2 game.
Yeah, I've got that as well. Castaway as well.
Yeah. And I played those. And I loved playing it on the console.
Mm. There's a new Battlefield mode, 5-on-5.
Okay.
That sounds cool. I might give that a go in my free time.
Is Battlefield 1 still going?
What do you mean?
It's a dead game.
It's the like EA's newest game at this point, isn't it?
Is it?
Recent Battlefield entry, it's still going to be going until the next one comes along.
I stopped playing it when they released the first DLC because I didn't want to pay for anything.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fair. But, you know, if you were to start playing it right now, you can now get the Battlefield 1 Revolution Edition. So that's a collection of all the content they've released so far.
What?
But even then, that annoys me because it doesn't come with a pass or anything.
So it's like a half season pass.
Yeah, so you get everything and then they're going to probably add some new maps in next week or something.
That's BS, man. That's crazy.
How old's the game?
Oh, I don't know. It'd be going on a year now. It'd be getting close to a year. Not quite a year.
Because if it was a year, as in like a 1 year
Battlefield
anniversary
4 was
type of thing, as in.
Yeah. Mm. This came out last year, I know that.
October 21st, 2016.
Ah.
Cool, nearly a year.
Nearly a year.
October 21st. Oh, it wasn't 2015. Damn it. I got really... The little Back to the Future nerd inside me got a little bit excited.
It's October 15th.
No.
Isn't it? It is.
No.
It is.
October 21st, 2015 in Back to the Future 2. That's where they go. I swear. Oh, God, I'm going
to
be wrong.
You are going to be wrong, and you're a Back to the Future nerd.
I haven't watched the movies in a while, okay?
It's August 15th.
That's the release date. I'm talking about the time they travel to.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah.
Mitch was so certain. Anyway,
Bethesda, also like Sony, kept a little bit quiet. They didn't really... They kind of just reminded us about what was coming out.
Hey, you can play all of our games in VR now.
Yeah.
Buy them again.
Please, no.
So Wolfenstein 2, like we said earlier, will be Xbox One X enhanced.
Like every other game.
Yeah.
It's just like, hey, this is going to work on our new console.
Mm. A lot of people got to play Evil Within 2. I think it was playable on the show floor.
Yeah. How's it look?
And apparently it is really, 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 really scary.
Good.
Way out of my thing.
Yeah.
Fine. Touching that game, man.
I haven't even played the first one, so I don't know. I'll think about giving the first one a go before.
The first one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Ooh, it was good.
She loves scary games?
Yeah. That's pretty much all she plays.
Oh. Wow.
And dating simulators.
Because she's so bored with you.
No, she plays weird ones like the pigeon one.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, that's right. Yes. Yeah,
she and she got Dream Daddy.
Yeah. Oh, that's the recent one that came out.
The Game Grumps one where it's just guys dating guys. Oh, my gosh. It's great.
Yeah.
Written by the Game Grumps, so it's really funny.
Yeah, other than that, nothing really from Bethesda. They just kind of did a big push for the new Dishonored, I think, expansion, single-player expansion.
Yeah.
Death of the Outsider.
Dishonored. Oh, right, yep.
Yeah, Dishonored 2.
That's isolated, isn't it? I thought that was by itself. It's like a standalone expansion.
I'm not even sure.
I think this is standalone, yeah.
Yeah.
Ubisoft Anno 1800. I've never heard of this before, but I looked into it. I think
the Anno series is...
They're like city building, economy simulators kind of thing. Like kind of like SimCity from what I gathered.
Yeah. First one was in 05.
Yeah, and the last one they did was like really futuristic and everyone hated it. So they're glad that going back, this is like the 1800s. So
Good.
Yeah, so... That's about it from Gamescom. There's a few little tidbits like PUBG is getting a NVIDIA Shadowplay highlight support.
Is that good?
I guess.
Okay.
Yeah. Final Fantasy 15 is coming to PC.
It is. That is kind of cool.
And then Final Fantasy Pocket Edition.
Which is for the
iOS and Android. Which, to me, they showed the trailer, which is the exact start of the actual game.
Yeah, it's just done in really kind of blocky, FF.
It looks so bad how the characters look, but I feel like it's the full game.
It's the same style as Final Fantasy VII on the PS1.
Yeah, but for a new game to go back into that style, it doesn't look very good.
It doesn't, and I don't like Final Fantasy games mobile consoles, because they're all on mobile phones rather, because they're all about $22 to $23.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
well, that's not fun to pay for.
No, yeah, and they're not very good either.
Yeah, like just mobile games in general, don't pay a lot of money for them. Yeah. I think I actually looked at the most expensive app.
It's an audio thing, isn't it?
Oh, I think it was a dentist thing, $400-$500.
Jesus.
Yeah, I can't remember what it did. I just looked and was like, wow, that exists.
Yeah. Cool. With this, you can be your own dentist.
Yeah. But yeah, other than that, that's pretty much Gamescom in a nutshell.
So far. There's more stuff over the weekend.
Yeah, I think, it hasn't quite finished yet. So
how long does it last?
Knowing our luck, the best thing will happen.
No, it won't.
Right now.
We're fine. We're fine.
I think it wraps up on Saturday, Joel.
Okay. Mm. Yep.
All the Assassin's Creed trailers have been announced. So that's all that matters.
Yeah. That's all that matters. Yeah.
That's you set for Gamescom. Yeah, and
that's it. That's all I wanted.
Yep.
My best moment was Kalthuzad, definitely.
I'm looking forward to that. And the nerf of Garrosh when that comes.
Not nerf.
No.
He's going to get a super buff.
I know he's going to get a super buff.
He's going to be able to fly.
Everyone's going to nerf him. He's just going to nerf him.
He's going to get a global.
Yeah.
Global means he can hit anywhere on the map at any point.
Oh, right.
Yeah. There are a couple of characters that have that.
Yeah.
Kalthuzad has that.
Including the new guy. Have you seen his level 20 trait of that?
No.
So one of his abilities is he can hit anywhere on the map.
With like a little ice spike with chains bursting out of the ground.
The level 20 trait, if he hits someone, the cooldown is reset.
Oh, jeez.
So it's like Genji's Dragon Blade. If he kills someone with it, it gets instantly...
More or less, yes, but you don't have to kill anyone. Yeah. You just have to hit them.
Jeez.
And he has snares, as in like 1.5 second snares.
How do you miss with the global ult?
It's a couple of seconds.
It's a couple seconds.
Like Diablo's ult with the symbols on the ground where you can run away from
it. Oh, okay. So yeah. It's not like a Karthus ult where one, like it's just...
No, no,
everyone.
No.
Okay.
That's his other ability.
Okay.
Where once he's locked onto you, you can't get away. It's locked on.
It's a very slow-moving medium.
It is. It is.
We don't have much time left in the show, but I wanted to touch on this.
Yes, I read this. It's funny.
How is this a problem?
I think it's great. It's representing Australia perfectly. So Overwatch is in a bit of trouble with us Aussies.
I think it's fine. I call it this.
Do you really?
Yeah.
So earlier this week, we got our first look at a new map coming to Overwatch called Junkertown.
Which I'm extremely keen for.
Yeah, it looks really cool.
I just noticed the walking sign in the top right of that image you put there.
I didn't put it there.
You put the image there.
Oh, right. I thought you meant put the walking sign there.
No, I know.
I was like, no, I didn't go that far into it. Anywho,
you okay?
The map is set here in Australia, and it's got like a Mad Max sort of setting going on, kind of showing the hometown of Junkrat and Roadhog. Sorry.
I saw the cinematic for this, and I was blown away. It was absolutely hilarious.
Three things from Overwatch this week.
Yeah.
It's spoiled.
And it's not even BlizzCon yet.
No, it's not. Aside from the map looking really cool, one small detail did irritate some Australian fans. In the trailer, we see a sign that says take out. However, we do not call that here.
No.
We call it take away. And so...
how dare they?
Yes. This started off with a post in a subreddit that eventually got the attention of none other than our best friend, Jeff Kaplan.
Oh, really?
Yes. It got his attention... And he sent out a very great tweet. I love it. He said, "I'd like to offer our direct apology to the entire country of Australia. Please forgive our cultural insensitivity. We will fix this in an upcoming patch." And he put in brackets, "The sign travesty will most likely go live for some period before being fixed. So we're going to have to deal with it for a little bit, but they'll fix it eventually."
I feel like someone pointed this out as a joke. And he just doesn't get it.
Yeah. Or I feel like he's being a little bit sarcastic there, like just playing around.
Yeah, possibly.
Yeah, possibly. I hope so. I hope he didn't take it to heart, because then that puts us in a bad light.
I think it's funny. Apologizing for saying takeout. That's just terrible.
Oh. So you said you use takeout.
Yeah.
You say takeout.
I grew up with a British family.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
See, I don't. It's takeaway.
Takeaway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Takeaway is the most common thing.
Yeah.
If you're people going to hear as in like takeaway, they'll be like, what the hell is takeaway?
What are we taking away? What is this?
Who are we taking out? Who are we killing? What's
takeaway? I wonder if they'll make it region based. So only the Australians see takeaway.
Well,
everyone else.
I don't think that'll work because as Australians, I play under the Americas.
True.
On PC.
True.
So I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
But so Junkertown is going to be an escort map. Really? We don't have any ideas when it's coming out, but it'll probably hit PTR pretty soon.
I'm keen. Yeah. I always like it when new Overwatch maps come out that are part of the normal rotation.
Yeah.
Not arcade maps.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Although I really hate Horizon Lunar Colony. That's
I
the most
love reason. It.
Really?
Oh, mm.
It's so hard because I don't understand it properly.
The gravity.
Oh, not the gravity, because that's only one little tiny bit of the map, but just in general, just defending and attacking on that, because I haven't done it enough. I don't know where I should be when.
Oh, I just go in and I'm not as high rank though. It's fine.
My only strat on defense in that is just to get an Orisa and just keep her in the middle on the point. Just people come in, just pump her. That's the only thing I know for that map. But as far as attacking goes, I'm not very good.
That's fair.
And it's why I always lose on
that
map.
You'll get practice.
I thought it was your team that always makes you lose.
Yeah. It's combination.
Oh, it's just, so you're admitting you're bad.
No, only sometimes I'm bad.
Oh, okay.
But his team's always bad.
Oh, his team's always bad. Yeah.
Actually, if I'm in a team that has a good understanding of the map...
That's when you're bad.
That's when they can carry me to the win.
But, are you complaining about that with Call of Duty?
What do you mean?
Having to be carried?
No, Call of Duty's... You don't have to be carried in Call of Duty.
Oh, right. Battlefield, you have to be carried.
Yeah.
You don't have to be carried in Call of Duty?
No, because you see the amount of crazy people that run around popping headshots left, right, and center, and it's just they're dominating the kill feed, like 25-2.
Okay, yeah.
Like that Marley 13 guy.
I
love that guy. I love his videos. They're funny.
Okay. I know exactly what you're on about, though.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
He's talking about, like,
I guess it might be a little bit different. I don't know what the kill streaks will be like in World War II.
Drone strike
in World War II.
They need to bring back their Tac-Nuke.
Tac-Nuke?
Yeah.
That's
only available on the Japanese map.
Yeah.
I've seen some of the score streaks, and they're quite interesting. Where you get to control a dive bomb, more or less.
Okay.
Where you're in plane, you dive down, so you choose when to shoot and then go up.
Yep.
One of them's like a Molotov.
You get
two Molotovs, more or less. Yeah.
That's crap.
It's a big area of effect. You get someone direct hit, that's an instant kill.
It must last for a while, too.
It lasts for a while. Yeah. So it's like a,
as long as they burn
point,
for a while.
Control point. It blocks off an area.
Okay. That's actually pretty cool. That's smart. I appreciate that. But yeah, I think I'll still give it a go. I want to try the beta, but there's actually no PC beta for this, so.
No. And you also got a pre-order. But then again, you can do the workaround where
there's pre-orders only limited. Like.
What?
For the beta.
For the beta, yeah.
This beta is only pre-order only.
The first one, but next week.
No, next week's also pre-order only, but it's open for the Xbox, I think. So the first one's PlayStation only.
Right.
And the next one's pre-order with like PlayStation and Xbox. But you can work around and go to what? Is it like EB Games? Put $10 on the pre-order, get the code, get your $10 back after the beta.
That's a lot of effort, though.
But it's like free. If you want to get it for free.
Or play the beta, and if you don't like it.
I'll just watch YouTube videos.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
You'll hate the controls.
Yeah. But yeah, that's about all we have got time for this week.
It's the end of the show.
Yeah.
Remember, you can follow us on Twitter at @replayAU or our individual Twitters, which mine is at Joel's Voice.
Mine's at AdamX1337.
Mine's at NimbleMimble.
And I'm at JordanDoThings.
Remember, we do have a Discord channel, which you can join us on that, which is tinyurl.com/replayAU.
Replay Discord.
I don't know that one.
Yeah. And then subscribe on iTunes if you listen there, I guess.
And can't comment. And rate.
Yes.
Yeah, right there. That any ratings kind of help us out a little bit. So.
Anything to add for the final tidbits of the show? You're very sick, Mitch. I can just...
I am.
Mitch is falling asleep.
When did you get back?
When did I get back? Monday.
Right. And you've been... As soon as you got back, you've been straight into work.
Tuesday night.
Okay.
Yeah. He's overworked.
You need rest.
Yes.
Do you get rest this weekend or do you have to work?
No, I get rest this weekend.
There you go.
That's good.
Everyone go check out the Assassin's Creed cinematic trailer.
And I'll be playing HOTS on Saturday and Sunday, so join me on that.
I will join you on that. I've been trying to stack up on boxes for this big event thing.
Oh, yeah. That's a good idea, actually.
Yeah. I've got 18 so far. I'm getting more ever so often.
Have you been going through just your level ones?
Yeah, more or less. Yeah,
good.
All right.
Cool.
Cool.
Bye. Same time next week.
Yeah. Bye.
See you later.
Bye.